What's up, good people? Mark Holmes here, and as always, I want to say thank you all for watching, commenting, subscribing, and being part of the Joe Boo Sports Report. Without you guys, as well as you ladies, you know that this literally does not work. You know, I've been doing some different things here at the studio, or the studio away from home, and I have a different type of microphone setup, which the sound should sound actually nice and clear when it's actually on. And unfortunately, like an idiot, I forgot to turn the Zoom pad on. I didn't mean to turn you on. Well, I didn't turn you on. So I ended up doing a video that went out, and shout out to Game Time Brian, who says, "You're an idiot. You got no sound. You triggered the Eagle fans." Actually, it's probably not that bad that I triggered them and they came through like, "Oh my God, what happened? What happened?" Okay, let's try this again. Now, Philly 500, you know, he's my boy. He's my son. He was talking before the season started about how great his defense was going to be, that they're going to be all world, that the 85 Bears had nothing on them. In fact, he talked about N'Kobe Dean was going to be leading the team in tackles and could be all pro. Now, I guess in a way you could say that about anybody at the beginning of the season. You could say, you know, I could say Mozzie Smith could lead the team in tackles and be all pro. It doesn't mean it's going to happen. You know, that's wishful thinking. So the 22-year-old N'Kobe Dean, who Philly 500 and his boy Joey Shakes went crazy over. And I say crazy, I mean, they literally went crazy about them getting him. Quite frankly, he's been a bit of a disappointment for them, so to speak. He's been injured a lot this season. I think he's only played in about 5 games. And, you know, Philly 500.
Grocery store, I used to actually swallow it, pause. But, you know.
Joe's packing and he used to.
I used to pack and swallow. I used to do a lot of stuff.
Dude, that should be your, like, intro.
Yeah.
You know? Your intro is just like the camera.
So, N'Kobe Dean. Okay, is their middle linebacker. He's the one that calls out the plays. Now has a bit of an issue. He's going to be going on injured reserve. He's expected to go to on injured reserve with a lace frack sprain, which is basically your foot. And as a linebacker, you got to have your foot to be able to push off. Going on IR means you're going to be out for a minimum of 4 weeks, which would be right when the Cowboys came back in a perfect world. But we've had Leighton Van Der Esch, who's got a neck injury, who we have been missing for quite a while now, is nowhere near ready to return from his neck injury. Who knows if he ever returns. But this is a big blow for them because they were actually low on linebackers to begin with. And now this is the second player that they've lost. Now, keep in mind, they are on a bye week, which helps them out a lot because they can have some time to lick their wounds. You've seen Jalen Hurts with some kind of a knee injury that they're not actually really divulging. That, you know, we've heard that it's a bone bruise, but it seems to be getting worse instead of better. Of course, Dallas Goedert has now got the hurt shoulder. Eagle fans are crying that we have a dirt, you know, we got dirty players. We're playing dirty. They must not remember where they literally hit Dak in the head going down on the ground when he was already in the grass and didn't get a flag call. Now, I want to keep in mind something here because, you know, Philly 500, he's my boy. He is my boy. But what's crazy is, anytime there's a penalty on the Eagles, he's always, "Oh, that's not a penalty. That's not a penalty. That's bullshit." Every other time, every other play, Philly 500 is always out there screaming, "That should be a penalty. Where's the flag?" You don't believe me? You don't?
Slid and he went head first at him. That's a penalty. Why do they call a penalty? First and 10. Gainwell's still on the field, mother. That should be a personal foul. Mother humping bullshit. First 10 at the 42, Hurts. Back to pass, looking, throws. He gets hit as he throws, intercepted. You know why? I'll tell you why. Because guess who's on the field? Kenneth fucking Gainwell. Kenneth Gainwell sucks. It's Gainwell's fault. It's all Gainwell's fault. Get him off the field. Fucking Gainwell. Get his ass off the field so we can...
Get his ass.
Every time he's on the field, we don't do shit. Gainwell just... What is he doing? He's just standing there picking his ass. What did I got my ass today? Oh, some corn and stuff. Oh, look, an undigested tomato. What is he doing? God, I can't stand this Gainwell shit.
Yeah.
Gainwell out.
That's Philly 500, of course, complaining about the refs.
Plus, they should have
called and Gainwell. So here's the thing with N'Kobe Dean. Now, N'Kobe Dean has been on injured reserve already once this year. So now here's the news with that. Here's the problem for him. But they've changed the rules, which does help. Dean's injury occurred during the Eagles week 9 over the Cowboys. So with that, because he's been on IR, he has to miss, if he goes on IR, Kansas City, Buffalo, San Francisco, and Dallas. Now, under the old rules, if you go on injured reserve twice in a season, your season's over. Now, a change has been made to allow players to return from IR multiple times. The only catch is each return counts towards the team's limit of 8 IR inactivations per season. So, if they put him on IR, then that means that's one less player they can bring back. And if they do bring him back. So this may mean that his season is over. So that's definitely some bad news. Again, he was projected to be a starter and, you know, the main guy. But because of the injuries and stuff, he hasn't been. So they're actually in a little bit better position than they were earlier in the season. But, you know. You're missing a guy, you miss a guy. And you start looking at this, you know, you start getting nicked up. Injuries were something that the Eagles didn't have a lot of last year. So we'll see how all this goes for them. You know, we've been dealing with, of course, Leighton Vander Esch gone and having lost Diggs, you know, early in the season. You know, it's definitely the next man up. And you know Howie Roseman, he has no problem going out there and getting more people. So apologize for having no sound on the first one. I think we got this shit right this time.